today on 15 on 15.
The Caribbean Journal publishes data stating Aruba's tourism in 2015 is booming compared to the rest of the region. Plus, check-in married, check-out divorced. Details on the concept of divorced hotels. And beach tennis gives kids as well teenagers a passion which occupies their time. Thank you for joining us. I'm Yentl Lieuw. The Caribbean Journal recently published an article citing that Aruba's tourism for 2015 is booming compared to the rest of the region. According to the Caribbean Journal, new data from the Caribbean Tourism Organization is showing that tourism in Aruba is booming so far in 2015. The Dutch Caribbean island received 294,411 stopover tourist arrivals in the first quarter of this year, which represented a 20.1% increase over the same period in 2014. While first quarter reporting is not complete for the entire region, the 20.2% number is significantly higher than most of the region's destinations so far this year. The publication goes on to state the boom is due in large part to tourism from outside the U.S., Canada, and Europe, with 68.5% increase in arrivals from areas outside of those three major markets, in large part from South America. Indeed, the 20.2% improvement came as the island saw a 12.2% reduction in tourism from Europe. Last year, Aruba welcomed 1.07 million tourists, which is a 9.5% improvement on the previous year. Aruba experienced close to a 10% increase last year compared to 2013. Based on the report, the island's tourism sector seems to be on a steady upward trend. Now, many other cities and nations around the world, like Aruba, are working towards sustainability. Recently in Miami, an environmental film festival took place in which Prime Minister Ayman represented Aruba as well as the Dutch Kingdom. Participants of the event say the festival is crucial in tugging at people's heartstrings and to have them on board onto a greener lifestyle. An environmental film festival tackles various global issues regarding climate change and green initiatives with the use of visual art.
The Environmental Film Festival has started 4 years ago, and each year it's been growing, and the purpose is to really educate all of the citizens of Miami-Dade County about environmental issues. We have a very unique ecosystem, and we want to make sure that people are aware of what behaviors they need to do to protect and preserve this for future generations.
This edition of the film festival was especially impactful with the bold representation of the Dutch Kingdom.
This year, though, is very unique because the involvement of the Kingdom of the Netherlands has been really instrumental in not only transforming our local community, but also the greater community of Miami-Dade County. As the world leaders in facing a new relationship with water, the Kingdom of the Netherlands has provided stellar leadership for all of us here.
Attendees of the film festival appreciated Aruba's Prime Minister's presence, and his vision for the island is acknowledged and praised. Organizers of the environmental event sees potential for Aruba to become the example for the world to follow.
Especially to have the Prime Minister of Aruba here this evening. His relationship with and partnership with Richard Branson of the Carbon War Room, making a commitment to really be totally renewable, 100% renewable by 2020, is a huge commitment. And already to be 30% renewable is astounding. So this says to me that the power of the leadership, whether you're on a small island country, a city like Miami Beach, or a major country, it takes the political will and the leadership to care enough to take the steps.
Don't go anywhere, because when we come back, we'll tell you all about divorce hotels, and perhaps a divorce could have been avoided if the couple would devote more time to cuddling after intercourse. Also, a play doll for adults. Those topics and much more coming right up. So stay with us. This isn't an ordinary doll. It's one for adults. Find out its grown-up features coming up. Welcome back from the break. You are watching 15 on 15. Forget destination weddings. Many couples are opting for destination divorces. Check in married, check out divorced. Here are the details. Taking a three-day resort getaway with your husband, complete with spa treatments, champagne, and picturesque walks through the grounds sounds like the perfect way to turn up the romance. Or, you know, the perfect way to get divorced. At least that's the philosophy behind Divorce Hotel, a Dutch company offering weekend divorce packages at six hotels in the Netherlands and one in New York. So here's how it works. You check in on a Friday to your own separate rooms, and throughout the weekend, a team of skilled mediators, therapists, and other professionals who are deemed necessary for your divorce will guide you through every part of your separation, from who's keeping the house to what needs to be signed and where. In between mediation sessions, you can take advantage of spa amenities, scenic bike rides, catered meals, and some champagne. And Sunday, you check out divorced. The CEO of Divorce Hotel says the marriage that failed should be the negative part of the story. The divorce, he says, should be the positive new start. The CEO also says it is the pressure cooker situation and tight timeline that keeps things amicable, rational, and fair, unlike traditional divorces, which can drag out over months or years and get very ugly. Divorce Hotel does have a screening process to make sure you are suitable for the program before checking in, and angry couples who can barely be in the same room together need not to apply. This experience is not cheap, but then again, neither is divorce. One weekend at a divorce hotel can run between $7,000 to $10,000. Keep in mind, this includes legal fees. The next time you engage in intercourse, stick around and relax afterwards. This will help your bond. Research out of the University of Toronto, Mississauga, shows that a little post-snuggle session can help improve your relationship. The study published shows that kissing, caressing, and long talks after intercourse are all associated with greater sexual and relationship satisfaction. Sex and marriage therapists say that oxytocin is likely the main driver behind this phenomenon. In fact, many people refer to oxytocin as the love hormone. It is released as a result of pleasurable physical contact and has been shown to increase bonding. Staying physically close after sex can also act as a form of nonverbal communication. It can help you relax, inhibit any sensations of pain, emotional or physical, and help reinforce to your partner that you are invested and committed to them. Aim for more than 15 minutes. That is the recommended amount of time to cuddle afterwards. The people in the study who said they were the happiest with their relationships did the cuddling thing for longer than 15 minutes. So there's plenty of sweet, innocent, and beautiful dolls for little girls out there. Comedian Amy Schumer and Comedy Central have decided to turn things around for once and create a doll that is not so children-friendly. This doll is filled with adult content. Check it out. It's pretty funny.
Amy, you're my best friend. We do everything together.
We love to have tea parties
and dance parties.
Get ready for a day of fun and glamour when you're hanging out with Amy, the official Amy Schumer doll.
Look, she's spicing up her coffee.
Why is it so bright in here?
Glamorous. 1 p.m. We're allowed to wake her up now.
She's waking up in a stranger's bed again.
She's so popular.
Uh-oh, no wrappers on the floor. Time for plan B.
Amy comes complete with a variety of accessories, including a purse for her essentials that you can dump on the table.
What's in your purse, Amy?
Birth control, Lexapro, dusty candy corn, and a business card from a TechServe employee that gave her a vibe.
Amy also comes with a six-pack of cranberry juice to help her UTI.
You'll feel better soon, Amy.
Dress her in three different outfits that hide her problem areas. A crop top.
This shows off her tramp stamp.
Skinny jeans to keep in the closet.
For someday.
And one nice thing for court.
Not guilty.
It's okay, Amy. You can fall asleep in your clothes again. Don't forget to sleep on your side.
It's Amy, the official Amy Schumer doll.
Let's take a very quick break. Here's what we have next. The growing sport of beach tennis is helping more and more young players to stay off the streets and be productive. Around the beach tennis courts at Tropicana, you will find plenty of teenagers and young adults spending their weeknights and weekends there. Playing a sport is a great way to keep healthy, but also it occupies time, limiting opportunity for the youth to be out on the streets or on their electronics for that matter. One of the most important aspects of the beach tennis sport on the island is the growing number of children and teenagers taking it up. Many have developed a passion for beach tennis. In order to be good at it means they have to train a lot, and practicing, of course, takes time.
For Aruba level, we need to progress more because we're not competing against the international level. So for us, we need to train more, like be more, like dedicate more. So yeah, training, it's all about training.
John Herrera is 22 years old, who spends a lot of time at the courts. When he is not training himself, he is part of the Caribbean Beach Tennis School, which gives lessons to kids.
It's a great sport because you're not on the street every time. You have league, so you can play every day. You have tournaments. And yeah, it's fun. If you try it one time, you will love it.
Those who play the sport guarantees you will love it.
I like it because, like, the competition you get against other people, you see the audience that you have, so it's good. I like it. I only have 1.5 years playing.
That is all the time we have for today. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll be back here tomorrow night, right here on Channel 15 ATV, with a new show filled with great topics. We'll see you then.